But the song's huge impact wasn't just down to its unique sound.
It takes on more fascination because of the historic role of its little film, which is credited with starting the video age.
There have been other music videos before Queen, but they hadn't been used as this one was used to promote the record.
I'll always remember Freddie saying to me, "Oh, yesterday afternoon we made a short film with Bruce Gowers." He didn't think, "We have changed the future of rock and roll," but they had.
I see a little silhouette of Jane and about a sun. Somebody, can somebody find somebody love? Okay, let's do it.
Guys growing up in the 70s, it's one of those bands that you have a tremendous amount of respect for.
I think you can tell, you know, when a band's got musical skill.
And I thought they were brilliant.
They weren't just a rock band, you know, they incorporated lots of different types of music.
Okay, there's a lot of show and there's a lot of camp.
Fantastic theatricality and campness that everybody enjoys.
I think they're great. Seriously.
They're a very, very talented band, and Freddie Mercury is very, very gifted.
Yeah, they had potential. The ugly one, what's his name, who sings?
Freddie's a real one-off, and at that time, nobody looked like him. Nobody sang like him with the harmonies and everything.
I like Freddie.
I like forever.
There's no chance for us. So for us, this world is only one sweet moment set aside for us. Who wants to live forever?
Choice was Who Wants to Live Forever, you know, because it was in a film, Highlander, right? And I remember when I first heard it, it was one of the few songs that brought tears to my eyes. It's a really emotional song, and so I thought, oh, I'd love to sing that. But then I tried to sing it and I thought, Jesus, I can't sing this. do you know it's going to be the end of my career.
See you.
Freddie Mercury sang all these songs originally, and he sang them better than we're going to sing them. He sang them in the correct keys, and he sang them with confidence, and he sang them really, really well. And his personality, vocally, and his whole projection is something that we can't capture. And the real thing about today is that he's not here.
Us and the whole audience.
He was a sweet guy, yeah, great voice. And a tribute and testament to him, which a lot of people won't click and understand on the day, is that a lot of people are changing the keys to these songs because they just can't do a Freddie.
It should be a celebration. Freddie wouldn't have wanted it any other way, I'm sure.
Group.
One of the biggest bands on the planet.
That looked great and sounded great.
One of us has been immensely successful.
I kind of got a soft spot for Queen somehow. Freddie's a one-off, you know. You don't get too many people like him.
Queen, that's something really.
They've always approached music very intelligently, probably because they've all got so many degrees and they're all so well-educated and everything.
Brian's a good guitar player as well.
He's the governor, you know. He's the best pop-type-oriented guitar player there is, really.
Sweet guy who is the nicest man in the world.
Everybody loves to play his licks, you know.
Like they should be playing mine, you know.
To me, they fall into the same category as the Stones.
Love of my life, you've hurt me. You've broken my heart and now you leave me. Love of my life, can't you see? Bring it back, don't take it away from me, because you don't know what it means to me.
You don't know it.
That's all right.
Love of my life, don't leave me. Stolen my love, you now desert me. Love of my life, can't you see? Bring it back, don't take it away from me, because you don't know what it means to me. You will remember when this is blown over, and everything's all by the
remind you how I still love you. I still love you.
That one.
They are totally recognizable.
Giving everything of themselves.
You've got this very trendy drummer, you know, hey, the good-looking drummer.
The man's got a lot of balls, and he's an original.
100% successfully.
It stunned you. The whole group stunned you, first of all, because they look so interesting.
The name fits the band, and it fits Freddie to a T, because the whole thing was so majestic.
Her Majesty.
First album I ever bought was Queen's A Night at the Opera.
Queen is one of the... You had your time, you had the power, you get to have your finest hour.
Radio, all we hear is Radio Gaga, Radio Goo Goo, Radio Gaga, all we hear is Radio Gaga, Radio Goo Goo, Radio Gaga, all we hear is Radio Gaga, Radio Gaga. Radio was new, radio, someone still loves you.
I think Freddie is very good.
King Mercury.
Oh, I like that Freddie, but he was not a queen, though, but I like him.
For a long time, I think almost all the music I played was Queen. I had a big addiction for a while there.
You've got the classic bass player who's sort of, you know, quiet and very into music.
He's a good bass player, but he should use a heavier bass.
Queen are the biggest in most countries.
So they must be good.
I mean, they make wonderful, pretentious, over-the-top music. But they're fabulous.
What a great gang of guys!
Queen stole the show. Queen were Live Aid.
Queen was one of the seminal moments in the history of the 20th century. Forget Hitler, forget the invention of the internet or whatever. Queen's performance was absolutely A1.
Queen's Day, I think.
Yeah.
They just stole the show.
Best thing there. Fantastic. Got shots.
On his way to berate the BBC, Geldof stopped in his tracks.
When I was walking along the top, and I looked out, and they started, and I saw the Radio Gaga. Just thought, this is extraordinary.
Radio Goo-Goo, Radio Gaga, all we hear is Radio Gaga.
This was pop history in the making.
Radio Gaga, all we hear is Radio Gaga, Radio Gaga.
Every single person in that whole place was clapping along to Radio Gaga and singing along. I thought, fantastic, I wish we had a song like that.
Freddie's command of the crowd even stretched across the Atlantic.
But looking out onto the audience, 90,000 Philadelphians, you know, on cue with a television screen, I just thought that was powerful, really powerful. And yeah, that brought us together. That was the one moment I thought, we don't have to be in London, we're here and we're part of it.
It soon became clear to everyone that this was a band delivering the world's greatest set at the world's greatest gig.
Everyone had been amazing, but this seemed to me to be of another order.
Through the backstage area, of all the stars, you have the unspoken feeling they're doing it. They're stealing the show.
I do remember looking up and seeing every single hand or arm in Wembley.
Live Aid was huge, man. How many bands played that thing? Everybody. Queen smoked them. They just took everybody.
my vows, but I couldn't close. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all. There's been no bed of roses.